That's just a little round bone about like that right there. You take that meat off.
All right.
We got Bud and Mark here. Learn how to cut up a pig.
All right. Let's make do it. All right. Let me cut right through here to get this ham off.
Okay.
You're gonna use your saw.
Oh.
There's a bone right here you gotta go through.
Okay. Right there.
Yeah.
You got right saw? Through the,
yep.
On going with the saw? Or?
No. Just use the knife.
Okay, yeah. Am I looking for any muscle separation there?
No.
In any particular place? Just kind of cut through?
Yep.
Okay. Alright, so that's the whole ham.
Huh? Yep.
Yeah, I believe that's huge.
Then just take the knife and just take that little bone off.
Looks like the tailbone, I guess, right?
Yeah.
Get a bucket. Go ahead.
All right,
we're next, bud.
Scraps.
Right through here, take that shoulder off.
Okay. Is that a saw cut or just a knife?
Yeah.
Just right along the rib?
Yeah. Well, you have to use a saw.
Okay. Along the rib there. Am I cutting all the way through or just?
Yeah, all the way through.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so now.
So, okay.
Now where is it going?
Yeah, just more or less straight with this cut here.
Okay. Kind of where the rib is already handled, basically. So, yeah. That's it. This is the spine still cutting through here. Okay.
As soon as you feel it go through the last of the bone, then
yeah. And then go back to the
knife. Let's
see, that's bone there. That's the shoulder.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's gonna come off with that though.
Oh, no, I didn't get through the ball all the way there. There we go.
All right.
Proper knife technique, right? Slice towards your leg there.
Yeah, just take it off.
Yeah.
Front shoulder.
Excellent. Okay.
Okay, now take your saw and saw these ribs off about here.
Okay. Just contour along the line there.
Just need to look at that without any time.
Esophagus.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll get that in a second.
Take the rib down. No, don't try to get real close to them, just because that's your ribs to.
Right. So you're saying like try to get under the fat some, like leave some fat on them.
Yeah, just leave a little bit of meat on them. And try to get them close.
So like this, you're saying just sort of leave some from there forward? Where do I cut it here?
Yeah, you cut around that.
Like that on top. And where do I go from here? Just kind of.
Just stay fairly close to the bone, but not real close.
Okay.
Doing this when they're limber like that.
Yeah. Few ribs, a couple ribs off of there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now that's your barbecue ribs. That's
okay. Right. So what are these other ribs going to be?
That's your barbecue ribs. These is what they call short ribs.
Short ribs. Gotcha.
Yeah, because they're short.
Yeah.
Okay. Take your kidney out.
Cook them?
Eat the kidney?
I don't.
No, I've never had
dog food for me.
Yeah. And you got to boil the piss out of them.
You have to take a knife. Yeah, you have to boil the piss out of them.
Kidney. Put that in the scrap bucket.
Okay. Take this fat out because it's your fat.
All this fat here?
Yeah, not real close, but if you'll start right here
okay. And
get it started.
Oh, I see.
It'll almost feel out.
Start at the back and kind of move.
Yeah. It's got a few gristle in it, but.
Yeah. Don't want to get too precise, but just to get the bulk of it on.
Yeah. Because that's all that is just fat. That's your leaf lard, what they call leaf lard.
Good for cooking.
Yeah, just render out for lard. And
so all along here, this whole bit here?
Okay. Yeah. That's going to be your hardest cut to do.
Okay.
Because you might have to have that sawzall to do that. You need to cut.
Oh, we'll get the.
Yes,
we're going to get the
meat saw.
Meat saw out of that. Yeah. Okay, where do we need to cut, bud?
You made that line for us right down here. So, how far, where do we cut off? Cut it like.
No, it. You need to probably need to take your saw and saw this off.
Okay.
Just straight across about like that. Yeah.
The bottom of the rib cage there?
Yeah.
Okay.
You can use this piece for bacon if you want to, but the most usually they use that for sausage.
I like bacon better, so I may use it for bacon.
Well, that's what I think.
Yeah.
You can use it for whatever.
Sure. It's a versatile piece of meat.
Yeah. This would be like your New York cut or your chest. Yes,
along the spine here.
Yeah.
So where will you cut the bacon piece off? Or this, whatever this?
Yeah.
Just skirt.
Cut it off at an angle just so you don't get into your chops.
I see. Okay.
Thank you.
Perfect.
Now this is
excellent.
Cut right through here. Take this on the meat saw and cut right through here.
Uh-huh.
This will be your, make a good roast.
This back, a little quarter right here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And all these we're going to cut into individual kind of steak type pieces and make it like a New York strip kind of thing. This was last is our what now?
Well, you need it.
Pork chop.
Pork chops.
Yeah. It's very trim a little bit.
Okay.
Like back here.
Oh, some of the fat stuff off the back side.
And this piece of shoulder bone. It's not a precise cut.
Yeah. Just get the bone out, basically.
Yeah.
Okay. Shoulder blade, and then cutting all this fat off of here, or some of it. That's what I can get off.
So I just take and cut this right.
The whole piece of meat off?
Yeah.
Okay. What's that going to go towards?
That'll go to your sausage.
Sausage?
Yeah.
Okay. Make a sausage pile.
You're a good roast, right?
Okay. Yeah,
right here, different spike roast.
Okay.
Just somewhere in the curve of that.
If we didn't do that, what would we do with the rest of this? If we didn't.
Well, you can cut the whole thing up, and that'd be your New York, what they call a New York cut.
Yeah.
Because you could cut the whole thing up. Just
sure.
Can we cut that off on the bandsaw?
Yeah, like right here. Sure.
You're gonna have to pull it. Is this meat?
Yeah,
it's gonna pull.
Get that on too.